Hi friends, I am Alok Mukherjee from Kolkata. In this episode of Making Loudspeakers, we shall explore about how we can make passive crossover filter circuit for subwoofer. We know that human ear can hear sound between 20 cycles to 20 kilocycles. For subwoofer, we have to make a filter circuit which ranges between 20 Hz to 200 Hz audio spectrum. Crossover network can be active or passive. Passive means there is no external power supply applied to the circuit. It is a simple LC network circuit that is an inductor coil and a non-polar capacitor. This filter circuit is connected between the speaker output and the subwoofer. The output of amplifier is filtered through the network and then fed to the subwoofer. Now let us see how we can make it. First of all, let us draw a diagram of the filter network with an inductor and a capacitor. This is a circuit for 12 dB per octave slope. The crossover point is fixed at 200 cycles. From calculations, we get the value of inductor comes to be around 6.3 millihenry, and the capacitor value comes around 100 microfarad for an 8 ohm subwoofer. For higher or lower impedance of the speaker, the values will obviously change. Now let us see what are the materials needed to make this subwoofer filter circuit. We need about 150 grams of 22 SWG enameled copperware, a plastic bobbin of about 20 millimeter diameter for the core, and a raw iron rod or core to fit inside the bobbin. We need a non-polar capacitor of 100 microfarad 200 volt to make a non-polar capacitor, we have to join the negative ends of two 200 microfarad 100 volt capacitors. The capacitor value will be half when joined in series. We also need a 3 inch into 4 inch size fiber board with three terminal tags punched in one side of the board for connection. Now let us proceed for the coil winding part. Now we shall start winding the coil. This will be about 350 tons, and if we use the full wear of 150 grams, that may be up to 400 tons. Let us try with this much first. The coil is now being covered with red adhesive tape, and the coil will be ready for use. Now let us measure the values of inductor and the capacitor by a digital LCR meter. So we see the value of inductor is coming to 2.68 millihenry, and with the iron core inside, this comes to about 5.33 millihenry. So it is little less than our targeted value of 6.3 millihenry. So we have to increase some more turns. That can be done later. We will proceed with this only. Now let us check the value of the capacitors, which are joined in series with the negative ends together, and we will be measuring across the two positive ends. When the two capacitors of 200 microfarad are joined in series with the negative ends together, the value of capacitor will be half, that is 100 microfarad. So let us check it. Well, we find the value of capacitor to be around 100 microfarad, which is our targeted value. So let us use it. Now we shall put some adhesive paper on the iron core so that it can be fitted tightly inside the bobbin. Now we shall use the fiber board with three terminals marked as input, woofer and common. On this fiber board we will be placing the inductor and the capacitor, and the ends will be connected with the terminal, and so the entire board with the components will be ready for use as a crossover network for the subwoofer. Now we are going to test the filter circuit. The red and black wire coming from the speaker output of the amplifier are connected with the input and common terminal, and another common is going to the negative end of the subwoofer, and the positive end will be touched with the woofer terminal. Let us see the results. Now we shall apply some low frequency audio signal from the audio generator. Thank you. You can see when connected with the filter circuit, only low frequency sounds are coming, high frequencies are eliminated. So this is a simple low frequency filter circuit of crossover network for subwoofer. This network can easily handle up to 300 watt power. For higher power, the coil wire has to be thicker, keeping the inductor value same. In the next episodes, I will show how to make 2-way and 3-way crossover for speaker system. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. If you like to see this type of interesting topics, please subscribe the channel. Thank you for viewing.